Have you ever spent hours turning the knobs on your oscilloscope trying to get a stable signal, but the waveform is still jumping around? I'm going to show you how the pros solve this problem for good. I'm talking about something just like this, a signal that's almost impossible to use. But don't worry, the solution is simpler than you think. In this video, we're going to look at your most powerful tool for fixing this, the external trigger. Simply put, a trigger tells the oscilloscope exactly where to start drawing the waveform. When the starting point is the same for every cycle of the signal, we see a stable image. We can use the signal itself for the trigger, or we can use an external source. So, the main question is, why do we even need a separate trigger input? We use an external trigger when we want to synchronize the waveform with a different reference signal. This is essential for accurately analyzing how a circuit responds to a specific input. For example, let's say we want to see how a simple RC circuit responds to a square wave. We want to see how the capacitor charges and discharges. In this case, our input signal, the square wave, is the perfect reference to trigger form. Alright, let's see this in action. I've built a simple RC circuit on this breadboard. I'll connect the output of my function generator, which is a square wave, to the circuit's input. At the same time, I'll connect another line from that same square wave directly to the external trigger input on the scope. Finally, I'll connect the circuit output, the voltage across the capacitor, to channel 1. Now, let's look at the oscilloscope screen. Right now, the trigger source is set to channel 1. As you can see, the waveform isn't very stable. That's because the oscilloscope is trying to find a consistent trigger point on this charging curve, which is difficult. And now, for the magic moment, I'll go into the trigger menu and change the source from channel 1 to external. And voila! Look at that, a perfectly stable and clean waveform. So, what just happened? The oscilloscope is no longer looking at our output waveform. Instead, every time it sees the rising edge of our square wave at the external trigger input, it starts drawing the signal from channel 1. This means we have perfect synchronization. We still have controls like this slope knob to choose the rising or falling edge of our reference signal. But here's the important part. The trigger level knob now affects the reference signal we connect to the external trigger input, not the waveform we see on the screen. With this knob, we decide at what voltage level or input signal will trigger the scope. So, in short, whenever you want to view a signal in relation to a reference signal, like a system clock or a circuit's input, or when the main signal doesn't have a good trigger point, the external trigger is your best friend. Thanks for watching until the end.